Hey, welcome to Rocket Football. It's the last season of the last game of the regular season here, Joe, and this one promises to be a doozy.
Definitely.
This Woburn team we saw in preseason, and they're a combination team of Woburn, Burlington, Lexington because they didn't have enough to field one team. Needless to say, yeah, they got plenty, and not only that, they took the brass. So they are actually 6-1. We thought they'd be 7-0 here because they lost 14-13 to a tough Draka team. So they are unbeaten. But as I told some of the Rockets at practice this week, listen, unbeaten means nothing. Means absolutely nothing. They have nothing to lose right here, this Woburn team. And the Rockets are going to get under here underway. Before we get started, while they're getting fired up, I had a couple of names I wanted to mention from last week that I missed. One of them was, you know, I actually called the wrong, you know how sometimes I call the wrong numbers of our players, guys?
Never.
Lucas Fleming crushed number 24 from who was it, Bill Ricker last
Bill
week?
Ricker, yeah.
And then the very next play, I said he crushed him again. He actually crushed number 14. So he crushed 24 and 14. I missed the actual name of the guy from Bill Ricker that he crushed twice. So Fleming was an animal. It was another crush. Patrick Duross was on the far side of the field, and he came in from a free safety and absolutely croaked somebody. I missed him. We couldn't see his name. And then number 14, calling his name 3 weeks in a row, Jonathan Grady, he popped up on a swing pass, popped up a pass and almost intercepted the thing. And you actually made mention of it, and I missed it, was number 12. Dylan Lee made a huge block on Fleming's touchdown that gave us a lot of breathing room. One other guy I wanted to mention, number 10, he played all over the field last week, was Lynchy.
They had Lynchy
coming in, split right. They had him over the center when Lorenzo was out. So Lynchy had a huge game last game for the Rockets. In the last few games, he's been playing quite a bit. So great job for Lynchy. He's a big body. We need him. The Rockets are going to get set to kick off here. And they better stay in the lane here because this is a very talented Woburn team here. It's nice to be home, Joe. It's about 60 degrees out here. It's perfect.
Football weather.
Stevie Needham back to kick. And here we go. Nice kick up the middle. He's touched that, so that's a live ball. He doesn't know where it is. The Rockets, he cuts up. He's got a little room. He gets ripped down by 73, DeRoss. So nice job by Patrick DeRoss right there. And Woburn's going to take over first and 10 on their own, let's call it 27. First and 10 for Woburn right here. They got three split right, two left, and obviously starting out in a throwing formation. They're gonna test the Rockets early on defense. He goes back, he rolls out the throw, he cuts up number 7, he's got a little bit of room. Oh, he gets met immediately by Damari, I think that's 22. Danny Damari comes in and cleans him up for a short gain. He had a nice little seam there, and Damari came in and cleaned him up, so it's going to be 2nd and 8 upcoming. 2nd and 8 for Woburn here. This time he has a backer just next to him. That's a set you've seen Redding do often. It's a direct snap, handoff up the middle, gets cut off, gets met immediately by DeCrescenzo. Put Kajander in there as well, and then Larry Lorenzo, the diesel in there. So three of our returning A players decided to meet up on the backer right there and give him a crunch. It's going to be 3rd and 6 upcoming. Here we go. Joe Dwyer with a prediction of a pass here. Certainly could happen, but they go I formation. This is a big play for Woburn. He's going to go back to pass. He rolls out. He's got all over him is Lucas Fleming, and Fleming pushes him out, and it's going to be a loss of about 7 yards. So beautiful coverage downfield, which was DeRoss, Patrick Dwyer. Troy Pollock. I thought it was 71. Troy Pollock back there in Needham. Excellent coverage on that rollout, and that's something that the Rockets worked on. That's what we talked about last week, Joe. Bill Ricker threw the ball, and it was a great test to see it because we haven't seen a lot of teams that do it. Well, Woburn throws a lot, and that was a beautiful play here. And look for these guys to kick it away. That is, if they get the ball back right here, that's exactly what the Rockets needed early against a very tough Woburn team. We'll see. All right, it's a 4th down play here. It's 4th and call it 15. He's going to be back. We're going to be looking for him to kick here. It's a big dude there kicking. And he does boot it away. It's not a great kick. Let's see where this bounce goes. The bounce, really, it's a rocket bounce, so it's going to be inside Woburn territory. The Rockets are going to start over first and 10 from the Woburn 45, and that's exactly how they needed to start here. Beautiful play by Fleming. I told you, you know, I made mistakes about the guys he's crushing out there, Fleming. But he's a guy. I didn't get a response from him, Joe, about
on his survey,
right? So what I told these guys, if I don't get a response, I'm just going to make stuff up about you.
Absolutely.
Although, you know what? Hey, you know who's a real character? He's a great guy. Is Lucas's dad, Lucas. Did you see him? Right? Last year, he had his hair down the middle of his back. He looked like he was in Blind Melon. Now he gets his hair cut. Front page of J. Crew.
I haven't seen him.
J. Crew, yeah.
Oh, we'll have to get him on camera.
Handsome guy. All right, here we go. First and 10 here. DeCrescenzo and Cajander, it looks like. There goes. Nice job by Lucas to hold on to that. He drives it for 7. Right behind Cajander. So that was Lucas Fleming and Cajander. Usually you see, you know what? One thing I was going to say about Dom DeCrescenzo, 32. Great to see him in here. He missed practice. He had a huge welt on his back, and it was really hurting him this week. He was a game-time decision here. So it looks like we're going to go Cajander and Fleming in the ground and pound early on that we've seen so often with the Rockets. Great job on first down for 6 or 7 from Lucas. Couple of big guys to follow one another, whoever gets the ball. This time it's Cajander. You know him, he likes to run over people. He's very, very close to the first down, depending on the spot. And we'll see. Maybe 6 inches short here. But it's going to be third and very short. And that's what we talked about last week. They've been ripping off some big plays on first and second down. And it's asking a lot, especially in four down territory here, Joe, to hold someone to a yard on any play at this level.
These big guys hit you, they're going to knock you back at least a yard.
We talked about it. I was talking to some of the coaches during the week about Jay Cajander and just how he would much rather run into you than run over you. We talked about it with his dad. Look at the hole for Fleming. He runs into Cajander, right? Jay, no one touches Jay on the block, and he comes in. The only guy who slows down Fleming is Jay. First down and then some inside the 30-yard line, or just on the 30-yard line. First and 10 for the Rockets. And in comes round two. It's going to be Damari and Beckenhuis spelling the big boys. It looks like Danny Damari back in a quarterback, even though it's going to be a follow there. He makes a little bit of room there, maybe for 2 yards. The snap was a little slow. You'd see people going off there. We gotta zip that snap a little bit to get the timing together. But Damari was in there for Pollock. I know that Pollock is dressed. Obviously, we saw him on defense.
Out there now, Tim.
And now he's heading out there. Pollock and Cajander go back out. So Troy had the week off last week. He was hurt. And great to see him back too. Those are a couple of big weapons that we need, which is Pollock and DeCrescenzo. Cajander and Pollock in the backfield. It goes to Troy. He gets outside. Troy is quick, isn't he? Oh, great play though
great
by
tackle.
This kid. Beautiful tackle by number 22. And that's one of the few guys I've seen, even when he pumps it to the outside, that could actually catch Troy there. But Troy has deceptive speed on the outside. It's going to be 3rd and 8 upcoming. All right, 3rd and 7 here. That's a pretty big Woburn team all the way around, Joe.
New offense for the Rockets. Hopefully they're fresh.
This is Troy and Damari, and there goes Evan Tice in motion. It's going to be a handoff to Damari, and he gets stacked up immediately. Number 43 puts a lick on him. And we need a little bit better push from that offensive line. It's 4th down here. You'll see the Rockets go for it and maybe put one in the air here, but it's a 4th down play here, and this is a big one. All right, 4th down and call it 9 here. Oh, we got a timeout called here by the Rockets, so Coach Pollock's going to reconsider what they're going to do on 4th and 9, and we'll see if they can come up with something to keep the chains moving. All right, 4th down play. This is a big one. I formation that looks like Needham, and it looks like Damari. Split right is Patrick Jaross. Look for him. He's going to go into there. Jaross is wide open out there if he's got him. Oh, wow, beautiful play. That was number 22 again. He made a nice athletic play. And you know what? If it was thrown a little bit sooner, Jaross had 4 steps on that kid, And Troy put it up. If we threw it a little bit sooner, it's a nicely thrown pass. Gave him enough time, though, to get back and knock it down. So Woburn is going to take over here. You know, Joe, we talked about this. The Rockets go with the ground and pound early with success. I like to see them keep going.
I think they'll go right back to it.
Keep going. Keep going with the ground and pound until they stop you, right?
I agree.
You know, they move it out. We've had that, you know, the Flemings and Kajanders and DeCrescenzos. I go, keep going at the beginning of this thing. Run these guys down. And until they stop you, you know. First down here, I formation for Woburn. Handoff right up the middle, cuts back. Oh, boy, he makes a nice athletic play there. Beautiful play by Troy to bring him out, but that was Kajandu who had a beat on him, and he gets around him. Jay's a little shaken up, but Troy Pollock comes in and cleans him out, but after about a 6-7 yard gain, so nice run there. That number 22 is a really good athlete.
Yeah, he's the guy, it seems.
All right, call it second and three here. I formation. Goes right to 22 again. He rips it, spins, gets pulled down by Lucas Fleming, but he's pretty close to the first down. It's going to be third and short here, I think. But, yeah, he's the guy you got to keep your eye on because he's already made a couple of nice defensive plays and a couple of nice offensive ones too. So third and one right here for Woburn. Quick break from the huddle. You got two guys split right, I formation. There we go, handoff right up the middle. Oh, gosh. He spins off the thing. He's still on his feet. There was three Rockets in there.
Looked like he had
Hokie, Damari, and Beckenhuis crunched on him behind the line, and he escaped out of it. So that's a play where the gang tackling of the Rockets, which has been so awesome, that guy slips out of it. And now they know, right? This guy, not an easy guy to bring down, but the Rockets get great penetration. It could have made that fourth and four, and instead we're looking at a first down here, about the 43-yard line. All right, Woburn gets set here. We got two in the backfield, two split right. He's in motion. It's going to be a keeper left. Looks like a hold right there. Yep, and it was. And absolutely crushed by Lucas Lorenza and Sean Beckenhuis. I hear someone yelling it's a hold there. I think it was Coach Masucci. Someone almost pulled Kajander down, but they push him back for a big loss. So nice job there by Diesel Lorenza and Sean Beckenhuis to get right in there. But that was all made possible by big penetration on the right-hand side by Jay Kajander. So we have Beckenhuis on the line there now. They've moved him on the line instead of being that he's in there next to Oki in the middle of the lineup. And there's Kajander. Oh, and Elk over to help is number 22 was Damari, but number 24, Diesel, and number 32, Dominic DeCrescenzo. So nice to see Dom back in there. He's a big body, and we need him. Him and Damari in there. So this is a little bit different. Look like here on the line, they have Fleming, Oki, Diesel in the middle. Sean Beckenhuis goes to the line, and then Kajander. So Beckenhuis, who we'd usually see in that middle linebacker position, they moved him to the line. Grady out right, DeRoss out left. Stevie Needham's the other backer. He's going to hand off right up the middle, and he gets met and crunched. There's the gang tackle we like to see. Right in the middle of that, Beckenhuis, Oki. A little bit of help from Damari coming in over the top. So it's going to be fourth down here. And you may see them kick the ball here on their side. It's fourth and about 14. But, wow, that's a nice tough line right there. That line gets even tougher moving Beckenhuis inside. So this is a lineup you may see he's treating this as a playoff game, right? Because these are the ramifications of this game, Joe. The Rockets are 7-0. If they win, they could take first place. We'll get to the play, we'll tell you. It's a quick kick. That one's a little better than the last one. We'll see where the bounce goes. Troy's going to just say, get away from it. So they're telling get away. It goes out of 30-yard line. The Rockets are going to take over. If the Rockets win, they could take first, Joe. If they lose, they could move immediately to fourth.
A lot of good teams. They're all teams with one loss.
Yeah, no doubt. So there's
AB
a lot of
one, no losses and ready.
A lot of
no
very
losses.
Good teams. Hey, Joe, one thing I was going to mention to you was I'm feeling much better this week. I got some good sleep.
Good,
yeah. Although, you know what I did? Listen to what happened to me last night, Joe. My wife, Sue, says to me, let's come in and watch a movie together. Okay, I'm already getting set up, right?
What about the World Series?
Listen, Joe, it's already a setup, right? Yeah, it's already a setup, right? Because I know I'm in trouble.
Yeah.
So, of course, what is it? It is a chick flick like you wouldn't believe. It's unbelievable. It's Me Before You is what it's called, right?
Yeah.
So Me Before You, right? It is it's like the movie gave me diabetes. It was so sweet, right? So here's the deal, right? 9 minutes in, Sue O'Connor asleep. Asleep.
This must have been a good movie.
9 minutes. I go, it took 9 minutes. So you know what I did after she fell asleep, Joe?
The World Series.
No, I didn't. I watched the whole thing and cried like a baby that night. My gosh.
You taped the World
The Waterworks. Series. The Waterworks. It was touching. It was moving. It was everything. No, I'm kidding you right there, Joe. But I'm kidding you. I didn't watch that movie, and I'm not even married. How about that? I'm just saying it for effect. Here we go. First down for the Rockets. Couple of big boys in there. Low snap that goes to Dom. He drives it and he gets met by a couple of different guys, so he gets about a 3 or 4 yard gain, and that's DeCrescenzo in there for the first time in the offense. Overcomes Kajanda to get play two. All right, it's going to be second and call at 6 here. There's Pat Dwyer split left. Looks like Kajanda and Fleming in there. Goes to Fleming. He follows Kajanda. Lucas drives forward. Drives for about 5 yards, and this is what we talked about, Joe. Keep it going, right? Keep it going with the ground and pound guys, the Kajanders, the Flemings, the
DeCrescenzo,
even Sean Beckenhuisen there. You know, these big bodies, these tough guys. Keep going until they stop you, right? They made a decent play on Domi DeCrescenzo, but you know we got 8 yards in two plays. Keep going. So it looks like Beckenhuisen and Fleming in the backfield now. Oh, it's a low snap, nicely picked up by Lucas. He tries to spin out, but unfortunately the low snap cost him, and he had to go down to get it. He's very fortunate it even came up in his hands, but it's going to be a little bit of a pushback here, and now it's going to be 4th and 4. Down play here, number 7, Jaheim Nortellis, going in there for the first time. You may see him cut across in motion. Sometimes there's a sweep. Sometimes you see him go for a pass. And it's going to be a kick here for 4th down. That is a bomb. Oh, nice play by 22.
Nice
it came
play.
Right into him. And he is quick. Oh, what's his name? Slows him down. Was DeRoss. And we have a flag here. I wonder who that's on. Hopefully that's on Woburn to push him back one. Usually on a play like that, you see a block in the back. And number 22 made a great play. He hung up in the wind a little bit, fielded it. DeRoss went over and grabbed him. It's going to be holding. That's going to push him back under their side of the field. So the Rockets do kick it away. They play in the field position game here. It says 7:41 in the second. Is that possible?
That's true. Yeah, well, they changed field, so it's definitely the second.
They did,
quarter.
Yeah. You know what? I'm just not paying attention out here, Joe. That's what happens. So you know what else I did last night, Joe? When I watched a touching drama comedy by myself with my wife sleeping next to me. I went over and found the biggest bag of Swedish fish.
Oh,
right.
So you're sugared up.
Do you know how many Swedish fish
That's
I
what
ate?
The diabetes came.
I ate combined. I almost called 911 to get myself out of there. I ate 172 Swedish fish.
You
Joe.
Counted them.
Yeah. Well, I counted what was left in the bag, and they said there was 175.
Oh, okay.
So there was three left.
Three left. Yeah. That was for breakfast.
Yeah. Well, no, this was last night around 9 o'clock. And then I fell asleep around 6 a.m. You know what I mean?
Good.
So, sweet. Listen, it's Halloween, Joe. This is a Halloween issue. What's your favorite candy, Joe?
Probably Snickers.
Snickers are good, yeah. You know what?
$100,000 candy bar.
I think Snickers are like what happens when you get old. Like, I love Snickers. When I was a kid, no way. Right?
Oh, yeah, when you're a kid, yeah, they're nuts.
Milky Way over Snickers when I was a kid. All right, here we go. It's going to be a first down here, I formation. It's going to be a pass here. He rolls out. He throws it up in the air. He's open. Oh, he pulls it in. Wow,
what
a one-handed catch from the big guy. And Troy Pollock was right there, and he pulls it in for a huge play. Jonathan Grady back there, and Pollock had tight coverage, and he pulls an Odell Beckham Jr. with the one hand there. I wish I played that kid instead of Odell Beckham Jr. He's been killing me all year in my fantasy. But that is a huge play in first down. And I would say that might have been an ill-advised pass, and they turn it a huge play. So the Rockets get stung by a big pass play, even with the good coverage. High formation here. They have handoff right up the middle. He's got a big hole here. He's got to pull him down. Nice job. Come back to help out was Fleming and Nortelis, number seven, in there. But he rips it off for about five, and it's going to be second and five here, getting into Rocket territory here, 26-yard line. Second and under five right here. Rockets D going to be asked a lot of right here. It's going to be a keeper to the right, and they're going to string him right out. And there is Stevie Needham right there, crunches him. And that Lucas Fleming in there pushed him out. So great tackle by Needham, number 44. All right, it's going to be third and three here. Clear four down territory here. So the Rockets are going to have to make a stop here. It's a handoff right up the gut. Gets met. He spins off. And he's still spinning. I thought the ball might have got loose there. But number 41 was right in there holding on, as well as 54 Oakey. Lynchy in there too. So he's very close to that first down. They give it to him. So it's going to be first down just outside the red zone here. And the Rockets are going to have to come up with something with 5 minutes to go in the half to get to the half. It's 0-0. We knew this one was going to be a tight game.
Diesel's in.
Diesel's back in the middle. There's Lynchy in there too. Kajander out there. It's going to be a keeper. He's going to look to throw it. He does throw it. Oh, my gosh. Wow, throws behind him. Beautiful coverage by Grady. Throws the ball up there. I think that was the same big guy who pulled down the last one. He's obviously got great hands. Looks like Gronk out there. It's going to be second and 10 upcoming.
I think he ended up taking the penalty because he marched that off, so it's going to be second. Initially, he declined it because he thought it was a loss.
It was a loss. He pushed him back behind the 25-yard line.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's the loss. There should be third and 12 right here.
Yeah, it should be third and...
Not second and 12, third and 12.
Diesel clapping it up.
Yeah.
Okay, ready? Go.
All right, Damari. So that one goes nowhere. Number 22 felt that one. Great play by DeCrescenzo and Damari on that last one. They got two guys split right. They got to get someone to cover them here. Troy comes over. Three split right. A little confusion on the Rocket side. Who's got who? He goes back. He throws it right across the middle. Throws it behind number 22. So good coverage by Damari and Stevie Needham right there. But poor pass, and it's going to be fourth down here. I think you're probably going to see him go for it, though, Joe.
And
look for the pass. I mean, it seems pretty obvious, right, that it's fourth down. They need to get down to the 12-yard line to keep the chains going. But this is exactly the type of stop that the Rockets needed. So let's see if the Rockets come up big here and get the ball back, do something before the half with 3:44 to go. Three guys split left to right in motion. He goes back to pass. He's got good pressure on him. There's a flag down. He throws it. It's out of bounds. He makes the catch, so it's going to be – there's a flag down, I would say, against going to be against Woburn, I would imagine. And they would decline it and take the ball right here. So it looks like the Rockets do hold up. The pass was completed, but he was clearly out of bounds, and it was well short of the first down anyway, the completed pass. First down for the Rockets. So that's a beautiful play there. They get down to the 22-yard line,
pressure.
And the Rocket D comes up. That was huge pressure right there. Great job. Kajander had a bead on him. A couple other guys, too. And here come the Rockets, first and 10 from their own 26-yard line. 3 minutes to go here, Joe. Let's see if the Rockets get something going. I see Musto going in there.
There's G.
Here's Troy Pollack heading in there. Grady in there on the on offense. Oki, Joey G. Pat DeRoss on the line too. 15 is Deemer. Lynchy in there as well. Adam Nola is going to be snapping here, number 40. In motion goes Tice. It's going to be a handoff right up the middle. He's met immediately. Number 85 takes him down for a loss. So need a little bit bigger push from that offensive line. All right, here we go. Push back there. It's going to make it second and 13. Rockets going in the wrong direction here. Troy Pollack with Damari behind him in motion's Tice. It's going to be a pass. He's right down the middle. He's got DeRoss. And Patrick picks it up for a huge gain. Wow.
That's excellent play.
Now, that's exactly what they had for the other one. And Troy this time gets rid of the ball earlier, and DeRoss is wide open, pulls it down
Beautiful
for
pass.
A 20, 30-yard pass and catch. And Patrick DeRoss, whew, now we get it at midfield with 2 minutes to go. We might want to keep our eye on the clock here, Joe. You know? I tell you, Patrick DeRoss is deceiving speed, too. That's two times in a row where he has gotten well behind the defenders, and this time they connect for a huge play. This one's a keeper for Troy, too. He's right across the middle and pulls it in. DeRoss again. He gets crushed when he hits it, and he pulls it in. So Patrick makes an 8-yard catch here. Beautiful catch. Takes a hard hit and still holds on to the ball.
That's a two-minute warning, Tim.
Wow, two-minute warning here and two huge plays, Pollack to DeRoss. And they get down to about the, it's going to be second and a yard. And 2 minutes to go here. There's going to be some nice clock management here. See if the Rockets can get on the board. All right, here we go. Second and one after beautiful pass and catch. Two in a row, Pollack to DeRoss. He's under center for this one. It's going to be a keeper again. And he looks across there and he throws it up into what? Oh, boy. He throws it in there. It's Tice is in there. He's got three guys around him. Actually almost went right through the guy's hands. Number 41 comes down hard, but that one might have been a little bit ill-advised. That was
yeah,
into some real coverage.
There.
You know, if you got three guys there, that you know, you might look for that second option underneath somewhere, Joe. Mm. But nonetheless, the guy who went up to make that catch came down very hard, and we're going to come back in a sec. Hey, little player profile, number 12, Dylan Lee. Listen, he made a great block last week.
A couple of great blocks.
To spring Fleming last week. His favorite food? Lobster. Huh?
Nice, good taste.
High taste right there. Lobster,
nice,
huh? Favorite male celebrity? Dion Lewis. He's the timing's perfect, huh? Because Lewis just got, he's been practicing with the team again here. No, it says, funniest movies he's seen? Ride Along. Have you seen that one?
No, I haven't.
No idea. I usually do my homework.
Yeah.
But I was too busy eating Swedish fish and crying.
Put you in a little
yeah,
bit.
Crying. You know who you'd like to be president?
No
idea. Dylan Lee.
Dylan Lee.
Yeah, a couple of guys. A couple of guys have pretty high opinions of themselves,
yeah.
Right? But I'm going to tell you, no worse than the rest of this team. Here we go, back at third and long. It's a handoff up the middle. Gets met. I think that might have been Fleming or DeCrescenzo. Let's see. I think it was Fleming. And now they switch out the whole offense. Well, that's the first down. Beautiful, because they needed the is that a first down?
First down, yes.
So they move it to the first down. I guess they didn't give him the first down. Oh, yeah, it was very short after the pass and catch for DeRoss. So why not check one down the middle, right?
But watch that clock, that's
they
all.
Do have to watch it. It says 136 and counting.
It's less than that.
The Rockets break. They're inside the 40. Fleming is behind Pollack. There's Nortelis in motion. It's going to be underneath. He's going to throw it right there. Oh, a nice passing catch to Damari. He cuts up. Oh, Danny Damari across the middle. That's what we talked about, dumping across the middle,
yeah.
Joe. We're getting better at this, Joe, right?
Yeah.
You stretch him up with a long one. Damari goes across, makes an athletic play, cuts it up for another first down. I think they stopped the clock on that one, called timeout, and the Rockets are inside the 30 at the 25 with a minute and 12 on the clock. Be great to see him get on the board here, because points obviously are going to be at a premium this game. Getting back to Dylan Lee, Joe, the place he wants to go, Alaska, right?
That's a second or third one.
You know what? I think it was DeRoss, right?
Because he likes moose.
Yeah, well, it was going to be Alaska. He likes moose, and then he said he wanted to fly, right? Which
right.
I think is what DeRoss also wanted to do. And you said maybe he can fly to Alaska,
there you
right?
Go. Your recollection is incredible. Oh, here we go.
I could be wrong, too. It could have been someone else. I don't know. I asked you before this thing, do we already do Dylan Lee this year? We may have.
It's okay.
You start to lose it at our age, Joe. But here we are. First down here in motion is Nortelis. He slows down. It's going to be a hand. Oh, it's going to be a pass underneath to Damari. Swings it out left. Danny cuts out. Nice job to stay in. And he's still on his feet. Danny takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's going to be another first down.
Stops the clock.
Two pass and catch plays to Pollock and Damari, and a nice job to get out of bounds too, right? He looks like he's going out. He cuts back, gets another 5 yards, first down, and stops the clock. So athletic play by Damari there, and it's going to be first and goal here, right at the 10 with a minute to go. So the Rockets are showing they can sling the ball around too with the best of them. All right, first and 10 here, first and goal, right, for the Rockets here. We have Fleming. We have Conroy and Damari split right. Nortelis split left, and Woburn takes the timeout. They're going to think about it. We'll come back. Right, Rockets first and 10 here. We got split rights to Ross and Nortelis and Damari. Split left is Conroy. Out in the slot is Fleming. Looks like an obvious pass play unless we see someone in motion. He goes back to pass. He swings out right. Troy, and he's going to keep it himself, and he's going to go to the end zone. Oh, no. They throw a flag on the end. And if they call that against the Rockets, they're going to bring that back. It was a beautiful play and the well past the play, so I can't believe that it would be any type of thing against the Rockets. They may call a hold here on the Rockets, and they do. Oh, pulls the touchdown. That's that halfback option, right, where he can take it himself or throw it. They throw a flag behind the play for a hold. And the Rockets are now going to be first in, let's say, maybe it's a spot fall. I'm not sure. I would think it's going to be first in at least 15, if not 20. It's going to be first and 20 now. And that one really hurts. That one really hurts, Joe.
That's first, a 15-yard pass.
Oh, gosh. They pulled.
Personal foul?
Had to be a personal foul play on the Rockets, which is brutal. Wow, the Pollock touchdown called back for what had to be a personal foul, and that one stings because it certainly was unnecessary. He was all set there. He's going to roll out now, and he's going to look back the other way. He keeps it himself. Oh, he gets met immediately. So Troy saw a seam and tried to do something with it. It's going to be second and 20. They call timeout here. So I'll tell you, Joe, that one hurt because Troy saw that he had the end zone open. He's fast enough to get there. He gets there. And then
had to be way behind the play.
Way behind the play. We saw it happen, and it was 15, too. So that's someone getting a little bit too excited there, and clearly we can't afford to do that with 47 seconds to go. All right, it's going to be second and call at 25 here. Second and goal, Joe, right?
Second and goal from the
So they got to get in the end zone or turn the ball over here. 47 seconds to go. All right, it's going to be back to pass here, and Pollock throws it underneath, right into the slot to DeRoss, and DeRoss scores. What a throw by Pollock. Absolutely threaded the needle there, and DeRoss is wide open in the slot. We haven't seen that play all year, Joe, and
right
talk about
middle,
mixing it up. DeRoss goes in, pulls down his third huge catch of the day, hits him right in stride.
Call, great execution.
Wow, what a call. What a throw by Pollock.
Yes.
That thing was a laser. Wow, what a great play by the Rockets, and they turn that unfortunate personal foul into six right here. You may see them go for two. All right, you see the Rockets here. They're going to set up for one right here, it looks like. Troy was our kicker, and he has a leg issue. So it's going to be a keeper right there. It's going to be Troy. He gets pulled. Oh, boy, does he get in? He does.
He does, yeah.
He looks like he was going to get pulled down there, and Troy puts his head down, breaks away off a tackle, and the Rockets go up 7-0, and they are fired up here, Joe, because like we were talking about off camera, they get the ball back here. With 40 seconds to go, the one thing they don't want to do is get one of these skill positions, 22
like
of the ball.
Kick here, Tim.
Yeah, keep
Just
this.
Pooch it.
Pooch this thing is righter. And
then
run the clock out here and get to the half with the lead. All right, here we go. The Rockets, Stevie Needham set to kick off here. About 40 seconds to go in the half. beautiful play by Pollock to DeRost for the Rockets, and then a great play by Troy.
Ball's loose.
They're kicking the ball around here. The Rockets, you know, doing a nice job. Look at that play by Troy Pollock. Did you see the Rockets coming in there not over-pursuing? They saw that thing go, and they stayed in their lanes and just moved up very slowly. She tries to get around Troy. He's not quick enough to do it, and Troy hammers him with a beautiful form tackle. And, you know, Pollock was getting very, very upset that his name wasn't called last week. I said, Troy, you're not playing, right? So he's just he's getting his name called on every single play, offense and defense. Here comes Diesel right now. They're looking for him. Number 24, he voted for himself for president, too.
He had to have a hamburger, I think, too.
Oh, yeah. Gosh, we haven't even brought up hamburgers once today.
Not yet.
I see Bill Cronin down there. He's walking around. We might have to bring him up to the booth for the second half. It's going to be back here. It's a pass play. He's throwing outside right there. Stevie Needham. Oh, right on him. Beautiful coverage by Needham. Number 22 almost pulled it down, and Needham hit him right as the ball hit his hands. And it was a nice-looking play. He's a good athlete. Number 22 is their go-to guy, and Needham was right with him. Speaking of another good athlete, Stevie Needham.
He is.
He was a heck of a pitcher in Little League.
He was definitely good.
So I don't know if I saw him pitch for did he pitch in Babe Ruth last year?
I don't think so.
I'm not sure.
He might this year, though.
I would think he would. They're split wide out. They're going to be throwing the ball here. No doubt. They better be careful about getting picked, though. Right there is a flag that's going to be holding. In comes DeCrescenzo. He gets pulled down immediately by, let's see, I think that might be, is that Grady? Jonathan Grady right on him. Jonathan Grady has stepped up his game like no one's business, and he's getting a lot of play as he should. He's right on him. They're going to move the ball out of the thing back here. If I'm Woburn, I'm kneeling on this
I'm
thing.
I'm kneeling on this.
There's 11
timeout. It would be nice to get time and be. You know,
there's 11 seconds on the clock. It's too far back. If they turn that ball over there, they could turn this into a disaster for themselves, and the Woburn coaches should kneel on this one and get to the half.
That's it. That's the half.
That's what they do. It looks like they're – are they calling it or no? We're not sure. We'll come back in a sec. All right, it's going to be a second and forever here. You know, I said this one, Joe, there's too many things that could go wrong. They look like they are going to try something here. Let's get a big push here by the line.
Watch that double pass.
They're going to try something here. Right there, Oki looks like he gets held. Right, oh boy, he was looking at the ball, so that shouldn't be anything at all. I think that's Grady. Beautiful coverage right there, man. Jonathan Grady was outstanding on coverage, looking at the ball. He tripped over him, and now it's going to be third and forever.
Or did he trip over his shoelace, Tim?
Yeah, well, I don't know. It looks like he almost pulled his shoe right off there. But nonetheless, great coverage by Grady. They're going to try another one with 4 seconds to go here. They have Pollock and Damari playing center field. DeRoss is back here, too. Saw Oki trying to do the swing in there. It looked like the guy was hooking him.
Sack for a safety.
We got Kajander, Lorenzo, Oki, and Fleming on the line. Everyone else back looking for that pass. It's Grady, Needham, DeCrescenzo. It's back to pass. He rolls out here. There's some pressure. He just throws it away. And I don't know if the clock was running at that time. It says 4 seconds. It did not move, Joe, so I don't think there's a whole lot of time left here. It's a fourth down play here. Man, what do you do here on a fourth down play? Why they even let it get to a fourth down is beyond me.
They must have such confidence in their passing game that they think they can get someone in the open field.
It's a fourth down and 25 with seconds to go, and they could conceivably turn the ball. They're going to have to kick the ball here
or
tie another pass, and they're going to turn the ball over.
Well, let's hope. Now, if there's only time for one play, they might throw it up.
It could be that. I mean, it's hard to tell here, Joe, because we're not exactly sure what the time is left. It looks like they may just snap and surround their guy and
run it out.
Run the ball, run it out here. Oh, there's a flag. There's movement right there. And in comes Lorenza, crushes him. Let's see who was with Lorenza over there. Number 41 was Beckenhuis. So he gets crushed by Diesel. Nice play. And there's a...
He's going to decline it. He's going to if he has time.
He's going to decline it. There will be time on the clock for the Rockets to get this. Let's see how this works out. We'll come right back. Joe, it looks like they did call it halftime right there. So the Rockets getting fired up right now. Beautiful, beautiful first pass. The passing and catching, three of them to DeRoss, two of them to Damari, were key in the first half. And the Rocket D coming up big on a couple of plays. So with halftime coming up, it's Reading 7, Woburn 0. Back here for the second half, I'll tell you, the Rockets, beautiful execution to get them up 7-0. They're going to get the ball right back here, a la the Patriots, huh? I wonder if they actually deferred it on this one, Joe.
I believe they did.
Nice kick right there, away from Pollock. Troy goes way back, picks it up around the 15. He's looking for blockers. He sheds one. Cuts back, he's still on his feet. Oh, he did the balancing act there. The tight wire, he had Grady and Needham ahead of him. If he kept his balance, there was no one ahead of him except two blockers. Could have taken that to the house. So beautiful return for Troy. And the Rockets going to start over here. First and 10 from around the, where'd they say he went out around the 32?
Tim, you're out of breath. What happened?
I'll tell you what happened, Joe. I ran back to the snack shack to get something to eat. I started blabbing.
No.
And I looked up and go, whoo. I gotta run back.
And you had to climb a half of stairs.
Oh my gosh! It was like Rocky going up in Philadelphia. I don't think I've the last time I ran, I think was sixth grade.
It was fifth.
Yeah. All right, Rockets take over here. We got Needham in the backfield with Damari back deep. It's a keeper for Troy.
Nice.
Oh wow! Nice hit. But it's a big run right there. Troy, he had one guy to beat. You know what? That's the one you were talking about, Joe, the keeper. They're spreading themselves out a little bit, and that's what the pass will do to you, Joe.
Yeah.
These guys have to account for it. Troy goes a keeper right off the right-hand side and rips it off a six. Okay, it's going to be second and three here. Upcoming. Looks like Fleming back deep. Just ran into Fleming's dad. High-fived him as I was coming back from the snack shack.
That's why you're out of breath.
Hand off to Lucas. Oh, nice little stutter step. Wow, he's still on his feet. Did you see that little move?
He's nifty.
He does a stutter step and rips it off. And he is pumped. He rips that thing off for about a good 10-plus, and they're into Woburn territory. Let's stay with it, Joe. Let's stay with it. Wow, what a move by Fleming. That's what I like to see, too, him going right between the tackles. He said, you know what? He's dying to make a nifty move, right, on each play.
That was a nifty move.
And that was one between the tackles as opposed to bumping it outside. And a huge gainer right there. Put him right back.
When he runs downhill, he's tough.
He sure does. They do it again. They call it again. And this time they catch him, but after a gain of about two or three. So it'll be second and about eight upcoming. All right, here we go. Second and nine here for the Rockets. Fleming back deep again. Pollock into center. Damari behind him. This one goes three times in a row to Fleming. Oh, there's the move right there for another first down. He dives forward. Nifty again. He sees holes, goes left and right. And three in a row, ground and pound for Fleming, and it's another first down. Keep it going.
Keep
you know what?
Going.
Give him a breather. Put Kajander in for one, right? That type of thing. They got the guys. See how Domi DiCrescenzo's doing. Let these big bodies, let them try to stop them. They
Woburn's
haven't done it yet.
They're a big team, Tim, but they're still, he's just blowing them away.
Man, they are a very big team, but credit that line, right?
Yes.
We got the line. We got Needham. We have, in this one, Conroy. Big 24 Larry's in there. Now it goes Damari, and Damari takes it for a bunch.
It's the line.
He gives Lucas a breather there. Damari takes that there. Let's see the other guys on the line here. Give him some credit. Is 52 is our boy
Dion.
Mason Dion, right? Einstein Dion in there doing it. I just saw Dion's father down here. They're pushing a – there's like a family of five that he's walking around with. I go, man – that guy, we thought Paul DeRoss had a weight. He's got two 8-year-olds. Dion's going to be coming to football games till he's 74 years
That's
old.
That's not a bad thing.
No, you kidding me? What you know what happens when it's all done, Joe? You just stare at each other. Say, so, yeah. Oh, way off there. They bounce. Okay, that looks going to be a free play. Guess what? We won't need a free play. We take the first down. They will decline this and give him the first down. Lucas Fleming has been a force on this one, and now we push it down inside the 25. All right, first and 10 here. Steady dose of Fleming with a little bit of Damari mixed in there. They've yet to have an answer for it, Woburn. Now he goes right, and no, he's got a huge blocker in front of him. Great play there. Fleming cuts back, and he gets down inside the 5. Danny Damari was out there. Both guys.
Was that Needham threw that block on the edge? That was a springer.
Was it Needham who was out front?
I didn't see
it. It might have been Needham. I thought it was Damari if he was in there. Either one of those guys. They had two guys out front, and neither one of them had guys in front of them. You could have handed the ball to Damari. He could have taken it in. So the ground and pound game is working. Adam Pollock is listening to us as we mind meld with him up here, Joe.
I don't know why, but
by the way, I'm up here. This is a huge play here. Let's get back to the series. We'll come back in a sec. First and goal. Guess what? How about Lucas Fleming? Lucas Fleming drives it in. Drives it for the touchdown. They snuck through there. Big number 85 thought he could catch him. He couldn't. Wow, what a series for the Rockets.
That was what you needed.
That
now you're up
was
two touchdowns.
A statement. That
a
was
statement,
a
exactly.
Huge statement right there. Keep it on the ground. Tell them to stop us. And they couldn't do it. And, Joe, I think we're getting better.
I think so.
Single time we come up with a coaching suggestion up here.
It's wrong.
They go, not only is it wrong, they go the opposite. And right. They're effective with the opposite. Right. This time we say go ground and pound. I think we're getting better.
So anyway,
I'm running up here, right? You saw me a la
yes,
Rocky.
I did, yeah.
And Ryan Pollock is up here at the top with his mom, right? And I hear Ryan talking. Exactly sounds like Adam. And he's like, I'm like, oh, my gosh, Adam Pollock's up in the stands. He's supposed to be down on the sidelines.
He must have sent the message down to Dad, ground and pound.
Here we go. Big play right here. It's going to be a keeper to Troy. Oh, he's going to have to keep it himself. And he's trying to throw it here. Oh, boy, look at this. He's still on his feet, and he throws it up. Oh, boy, it gets intercepted. No, that's all right. They can't move it ahead. But
okay.
Troy doing everything he can to keep that play going.
What the heck?
That
nothing
was
to
good
lose.
Coverage. They were looking for DeRoss, and they had good coverage on him. But with 6:13 to go in the third, the Rockets 13, Woburn nothing. Good time. Back to Coach Pollock. We had these guys fill out some surveys for us, too. Mm. Coach Pollock's favorite food, steak and sushi.
Steak and
together?
Sushi. Surf and turf.
Ah, I got you. So, you know what? He probably should head out with Anthony Masucci. Anthony Wasabi Masucci. Favorite male celebrity? He's going old school. Bobby Orr. It's one of the best, huh? You actually were college roommates with him, weren't you, Joe?
Bobby Orr?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, you actually graduated before him.
Yeah, it was Gump Worsley.
All right, here we go. It's a nice kick here by Needham. Oh, wait, what are they calling here?
No.
Calling no play. I don't think they were ready over there, but that was a beautiful kick by Needham. Getting back to Coach Pollock, his favorite female celebrity, Shania Twain.
Mm.
You know what? Now that I say this, I think we might have done a profile of Coach Pollock earlier. Are we going back to Shania Twain? Someone else do it.
I haven't heard her name in a while, Tim. So,
how about this? The team that would get the team pumped up, the A-team song would get us pumped up, Eye of the Tiger.
Mm.
Yeah. That was popular 74 years ago, Joe. Eye of the Tiger.
Isn't that Rocky?
Survivor.
No.
Yeah, it was from Rocky. Rocky. Yeah. Yeah, Eye of the Tiger. It was Survivor's one hit, and they've been working it for 35 years. His Needham. Last kick was great, and this one's good, too. He tries to get out of the way.
Loose.
That's a live ball. Wow.
Nice hit.
Good play right there. Adam Pollock could have picked that thing up and taken it in. So the guy gets out of the way so it doesn't hit him. And Pollock is right on top of him. And Ruben's going to take over first and 10 from their 29. All right, here we go. First and 10 here for the Woburn. 6 minutes to go. The Woburn, yeah. In the third quarter, 6 minutes to go. They're going to have to start slinging the ball. They slide it out right. There's Pollock. He's right on top, and wow, he slides out and gets pushed out by Kajander. Grady there as well, so no one faked nobody on that play.
Yeah, watch it's that later, Tim, with a double pass.
They're going to try to set it up is what they're doing, Joe, right? Because they're going to need it. They're going to need some long plays, so they try to set that one up early to have these guys jump on it, but they're going to look for that double pass later. I like it, Joe. I think you're using your peanut-sized brain.
That's right. Yes, it's maturing.
Hey, here's no surprise about Coach Pollock. Favorite animal? What's his favorite animal?
A dog,
of course. Yeah, he's a dog guy, for sure. And they just got a new German Shepherd
awesome
puppy.
Dog.
I think it's, is it Sadie?
Sadie or Sophie?
I think it's,
we
I don't know.
We should know that, Tim.
We should know that. But I just saw Adam's daughter walking the dog around the park as I was running past her 2 miles an hour. All right, here we go. Back pass. Oh, Oki's right in his face. Beautiful pursuit. There was three guys in there. There's Fleming and Kajanda, too. Danny O'Connor got right through it. He wanted it. So Oki had huge pursuit there. Has to throw the ball away. That defensive line is starting to wear these guys down.
This is a big play, Tim. If we can make them punt here.
Huge play, Joe, because it's a little too early to be getting cute here. They might have to play the field position game. And fourth and 10 from their own 30, you have to play field position with a quarter and a half to go. But this is a very, very big play. We have Nortellis, Damari, Needham, Pollock, Grady in the backfield with DeRoss on the other side. Pass play, looking to come here. High snap, he keeps it, gets mashed by Oki.
Okay.
In comes, absolutely crushed, and then Larry Lorenza comes in and crushes behind him. So Danny O'Connor busts through on a huge play and crushes. Wow, what a big play right there, huh? And it's fourth and for now it actually makes the call easier. They have to kick here. So with a big play right there, number 54, Oki comes up huge, and Diesel Lorenza comes in with a little
sandwich on top.
There's no Larry Lorenza. Oh boy, high snap, great play just to get it away. Troy's back to field it. He does field it. Right there, Troy's got a seam. Oh, boy, he's got more. He's got room. Oh, what a hit by Oki. Oki rolls him and strikes him. And Troy goes to the house. Oh, for good measure. good measure. Absolutely crushes someone here, but there's a flag down way back in the play.
Tim, that had to come very late.
Oh, please don't tell me that's against the Rockets after that play.
It has to be.
Troy Pollock finds a seam. Danny O'Connor crushes a block on the way back, and then Fleming, when he's already in there, coach is telling him, Lucas, you don't have to do it. And I don't know what the call is here. I think they're bringing this thing back. And that is a killer. And Reuben absolutely lucks out on that play because it's going to be – that must have happened way early, Joe, because it's behind the play. It's at the 50-yard line. Pollock finds a seam. I didn't see it. It certainly wasn't on Nortellis. Oki puts a huge block to spring him. And at the very end, did you see what Fleming did to their player?
I did not.
Oh, my gosh. You'll see it on film. It was probably unnecessary, but legal. And Fleming crushes another blocker for Pollock to go in, and they're going to pull this thing back.
That's a shame.
That is a shame because it was a couple of really great plays on that one. And you know what?
Let's ground and pound them.
I'll tell you this, Joe. That's what's frustrating. We had two calls now that have pushed them, effectively taking touchdowns away.
Right.
Right? And listen, 13-0, we're in a good position. But two calls to take back touchdowns, I suppose if that was a call that sprung them for the touchdown, then you get what you deserve.
But early on, Tim, I looked. I didn't see
I saw nothing. Certainly nothing behind the play. That would be an interesting one to go back on and check out. But the Rockets are going to take over here from now their own 40. And you know what? This is the type of play that Troy gets really, really angry about. And he's like, guess what? You made me run. I ran 50 yards for a touchdown. I'm going to make you pay. Yeah. But we're going to ground and pound right here. We got Kajander and Dom DiCrescenzo in there. Nice to see Dom in there. He's been hurt all week. Goes to Kajander. He gets outside. Nice block ahead of him right there. Oh! Kajander will not go down while they try to strip the ball. Jay Kajander gets 20 back in a hurry. And it was a beautiful block out there. I could see him with the red sleeves. It was number 81 out there with Zach Kenyon had a monster block right in front of him. So Zach Kenyon had a huge play there to spring Kajander. Beautiful block by Kenyon. 4 minutes and counting in the third here. This game is awesome, Joe. This is playoff level game right here. This one goes to DeCrescenzo. What a hole he has. He just sheds this guy, and he rips it off for about another 12, 13 right there for first down. And there are some big lanes for these runners to go through for Reading.
That offensive line, Tim.
Dominating the line. You know who's in there? The Greek Freak. Pete Mariaginis. We have 43, Max Ramos in there. 51, the Worm. Giancarlo Musto's in there. 50's in there. Big Logan Fortuna. These guys just opened up a hole you and I could have run through. Beautiful play by the line there.
This is a big Woburn team they're pushing around. And a good Woburn team.
Yeah, I'll tell you this, man. They are the Rockets. This is a big test for the Rockets, and this is where maybe strength of schedule really helped us out.
I think so.
They try to jump here. It's a low snap. They got to get that ball. Beautiful play by Troy just to hop on it.
Smart.
So they look. Actually, you know what? Troy lifted up because a bunch of guys jumped off sides, and then the snap went a little bit low. And they're going to swap out the entire line right now. But you know what? We talked about strength of schedule, Joe. The Rockets have had a very, very tough schedule. The only guy – well, I will say this. It's a tough league. We haven't seen Acton, Boxborough, Malden, and they were tough.
They were tough.
Those guys, AB beat them. But the Draka team took out Woburn last week. We saw them. And that game – that was a game we handled, but it was a lot closer than it should have been. 18-14 for us. But it's showing right now. And we got Lorenza and Damari. Fleming in the backfield. Two Lucases. They're messing me up. That's why they call one Larry. He's going to go back to pass. He throws it over the middle. Oh, boy. He has DeRoss open again, and it was just a little bit straight over his head. And he had him deep, wide open again, and the pass was just a little bit behind. It wasn't behind. It wasn't short, but it was behind, and couldn't catch up with it.
I like
was
the play
DeRoss.
Call, Tim. The formation showed no receivers, and
didn't
expect the pass.
None at all, and a one-on-one with DeRoss. DeRoss has been abusing the backfield today, abusing them. 12 play here. I'd say four down territory, too, right?
I would think so.
They showed that Fleming run, right? They showed the run, but now they're going to look, and we got Nortelis up top. Conroy, Damari, there's Nortelis in motion. It's going to be a swing pass to Danny Damari. Danny cuts up. He gets pushed down. Blocked by Conroy there. Almost sprung him. And it's going to be a fourth down play, but they get about eight back here. So look for the Rockets to go for it here deep in Woburn territory. And if they convert this one, Joe, it could be all she wrote for Woburn.
Hey, Tim, we have the chain gang over there. I believe we have Paul DeRoss.
Paul DeRoss and Steve DeCrescenzo. It's a couple of volunteers for us.
He was wearing a mask earlier on. I can't tell if it's still on there or not.
Well, he's wearing a mask.
A Halloween mask.
Oh, yeah. Well, see if you can zoom in.
That's as far as I can go.
You know what? I can't tell if he still has that mask on.
I can't
on,
either.
You know what I mean? All I know is it was big and ugly, right?
Yeah.
So, hey, listen, Steve DeCrescenzo, Paul DeRoss have done the change for us, so we want to give them a big high five for being our volunteers. Paul DeRoss has his costume on. If you see him,
he's right there.
Yeah, he's dressed up as Clark Kent.
Yes.
Yeah, he's got those big, thick black glasses.
He's texting Lois Lane. Right
yeah,
now.
He's just gonna rip his. He's checking his fantasy scores, but probably. he's gonna rip his glasses off, rip open his shirt. There'll be a big S under there.
Big S.
Hey, you know who's wearing the big S? His son Patrick.
Yes,
today
he is.
Right now. So Steve DeCrescenzo, actually, what's funny, Steve comes in with a mask on, right? And I knew it was him, so I said, let's just very matter-of-factly go, hey, Steve, how you doing?
Yeah.
Gave him that one today.
Yeah, there he is. All right, back to the game.
Back to the game here. DeCrescenzo and DeRoss, they're both checking their phones right now. They're checking the Patriots score. Do not tell Coach Gilligan.
Ever.
Guess what? He'll be seeing this later, but the Patriots are dishing a beating on Buffalo right now. All right, here we are. Big fourth down play here. It's going to be a keeper. Nice block by Damari. Oh, he's going to keep it here. Troy's got room. He's looking for a block. He cuts up. Oh, he fights for it. He gets ripped down there. He's
going to
give him the first. That's a first down.
I think so.
He's over that line, and he deserves it.
Yes.
Huge. He is over that line, and that – oh, look at the spot. Troy's calling for it. He's got to give it to him. He was over. This is a huge call right here. Let's see what they do. That is absolutely a first down. He was over that line, and he spun him back. Yes!
Yeah.
Huge first down play right there. What a play by Pollock. They had good coverage. He pulls it down. He's calling for a blocker. He realized he had to do it himself. One on two, Pollock makes it happen. With 1:09 left in the third, the Rockets are threatening here. The 20-yard line, I'll tell you, like we said, if they go in and punch one in here, Joe, that is huge for Reading. And I'm going to say this, with the exception of the two penalties that brought them back, the Rockets have come to play today, haven't they?
They have. No mistakes, and they
should win mistakes. This. I mean, with, you know, we could take a look in the film on some of those on those calls, but nonetheless, every facet of the game, the Rockets are pushing these guys around. And let's see if they can do it again. This is going to be a pass to Troy. He swings it out. Oh, look, there is no one in front of Fleming. Oh, he's spin around. He's still on his feet. He's diving for
it. Right down to the one.
What a play by Lucas Fleming. What a beautiful play call. They swing it out to Fleming. There were guys there with their eyes were huge looking at Fleming bearing down on him. He comes in. Two guys hit him. He bounces off. He does a spin move to get down inside the 5-yard line. It's first and goal here. Rockets, and Fleming and Pollock have been superstars today. All right, first and 10 here. I'm going to throw another superstar, 73, is Pat DeRoss.
Yes.
Oh, those three guys have been killer, but I'll tell you know what's been allowed them to do it? The line. The offensive and defensive lines have been phenomenal, and there's a timeout call in the field. This actually looks like it's going to be the fourth quarter, so they may be switching sides right here, and the Rockets threatening to put this one out of reach. Hey, we talked about the big sausage right there. We have had a lot of fun with Coach Dan Damari, and you know what? The only reason I do it is because I know he's such a great guy. Some of these other guys, you start ragging on them, and they're going to be knocking on your door.
Yeah,
but Damari is one of the nicest guys in Reading, right? His favorite food, great steak, right? His favorite male celebrity, former retired coach Bob Giunta. Last year, you said. Now, listen to this one. This is very controversial from last year. His favorite female celebrity, the one and only. Oh, boy, here's the extra play here. Oh, Damari gets absolutely holding. He's getting pulled down by his mask. I'm talking about his dad. He's running in a touchdown. Hey, you know what? That's a good omen because every time I bring up a player profile, either his kid or himself, they do something great, and Danny Damari takes it off tackle for a touchdown. And we're having fun here thinking it's halftime.
Hijinks, Tim.
Oh, my gosh. That's all right. You know what? Coach Dan Damari would appreciate it because at least we're talking about him.
Well, I said to him the other day, I said, I hope you don't mind talking about you on the broadcast. He said, you know what he said?
What'd he say?
Bring it on.
Oh, boy. All right, so let's see this extra point before we get back
so we don't miss
Big Dan.
One,
yeah. His son, Dan, goes off tackle, gets ripped down by the face mask. We can see it from here. They don't call it. Nothing. Oh, and now Fleming's going to try the extra point. Oh, he's got the height, and does it go through?
Well, they don't know.
Yeah, they don't know, care. Does anybody calling anything? I didn't see anything waved off. He had the height. I think it might have went right.
It went wide, yes.
So it went wide, but the two Lucases are messing me up now too. Lucas Fleming and Lorenzo.
One's the Diesel.
Yeah, that's right. I gotta keep going to Diesel.
Just call him Diesel.
So anyway, very controversial. It says who's his favorite female celebrity? The one and only Jill Damari.
Oh.
Yeah. Now I don't know if he's making that up because last year he said there was a girl named Tori Kelly who's a singer.
Oh yeah.
And
kind of in trouble.
Yeah, I think he got a lot of trouble. Yeah. So by the way, here's a little known fact about the Damari family. Jill Damari apparently had won community auditions in the 80s. So he's literally he says YouTube early 80s community auditions winners for Jill Damari.
Is that on the web?
Oh, my gosh, it has to be. That would be outstanding. And by the way, we know we get a playoff game, so there's one of the things we're going to do for the next game, Joe, is win or lose, we have a playoff game, and we are going to go through the archives right now of community auditions to find – we have to find her maiden name.
Oh, well, that's easy.
Yeah. We'll just casually bring it up because they only watch these things a week later. The Rockets go up 19-0 here with Danny Damari, little Dan Damari, bringing it in. Stevie Needham boots it. Great kick by Needham. Fielded cleanly. Right there. Beautiful play by, I think it's Pollock over there. getting pushed around, getting back to Big Dan, right? What's the funniest movie you've ever seen? He said, any Pollock family reunion. How about that, huh? He's spreading the wealth right there. He's spreading the wealth. So the one place he'd like to visit is the Masters at Augusta. Like to do that, too. Yeah, it looks like Troy gets shaken up over there in the corner. They're going to go check him out.
The Masters would be sweet, huh?
The Masters would be something, huh?
Tough to get in.
And how about this? If I had a superpower, what would it be? He goes, go back in time, maybe change a couple things.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. What would you change, Joe?
I don't know. I have to think about that, Tim. That's a deep question.
I have 4,254 things I want to change on my list. No, actually, I have nothing to change, Joe. Right?
Yeah, I'm not complaining.
You know why? Because I have such a short memory. I don't even remember what happened 3 days ago.
If you go back 14 years.
I'm not one of these positive guys who's always looking forward. That's the only way I can look. I can't even remember anything. And, hey, they're going to check out Troy over here on the backside here. The Rockets, with 9:48 to go, are absolutely pushing this Woburn team around. And they're sending a message right now. Because it's playoff time this week, Joe.
Yeah.
And there'll be a game either Wednesday or Thursday of this week.
A one or two seed.
A one or a two is going to give you a team that you probably played or handled, right? But a four seed means you're going to be playing a very good team in that first game. And that could be that Woburn team, the way things are going now. Look for them to start throwing the ball around here. They try that swing pass again. Oh, there you go, right there. We talked about that one. And there's Nortelis over there stepping in for Is that Jaheim? I think it was in there, yeah. And Needham was over there, too. But you saw that, Joe, right? He looked like he was going to try to double pass. Jaheim Nortelis all over him. Hey, getting to Jaheim, because Jaheim just joined us, too. Danny DeMari was calling him Jar Jar Binks. And he says, yeah, you can call me Jar Jar Binks. I go, he's the least liked Star Wars character ever. And then Jaheim goes, no, don't call me Jar Jar Binks. Just make it Binks.
Just Binks.
So I guess Binks is cool, but I don't know who'd want to be named after Jar Jar Binks. It almost ruined a billion-dollar enterprise. All right. Oh, inside. Hit the ball to the ground. Oh, I think the Rockets have it. Oh, boy.
Yeah,
they come up with it. It's Kajander. Jay Kajander comes up with it, and they try an inside handoff. I would have loved to see who got in there. I don't know if it was just a missed exchange, Joe, or there was
a
hit.
Exchange.
Mixed exchange, and four guys are in there. DeRoss, Oki, Grady, and Kajander, and Jay comes up with it, and the Rockets are taking over first and 10 inside the 30, 8 minutes to go, and that's exactly what Woburn couldn't afford to do this late.
For them quickly now.
I tell you, they look like they're playing a lot of the same guys here. They got a big roster over there, but they look like they're just getting worn down by this Rocket line. And Jay Kajander is there high-fiving everybody over here. Coach Richie Marshall, he's Jay Kajander is about a foot taller than Coach Marshall. See, oh gosh, Richie's go. He'll kill me later. Here we go.
We've died many
facts
times.
Are facts. Oh, right up the middle to Fleming. Ah, oh, he just wants to carry a couple people with him for about 5 yards. That ground and pound drive with Fleming was awesome.
You know, Tim, when they started this game, I saw the size of that line, and I was a little concerned, but the offensive line is just opening holes.
Oh, Deemer in there. Lynchy. We talked about Lynchy. They used Lynchy in a couple of different sets last week. They had him split out right like a receiver, but it was set up for him to chop block and open, you know, not chop block. That's illegal, right? But seal block, right? They let him spell Larry Lorenza, and then he's playing his regular gig on both sides of the line. And Lynchy's a big dude. He's a tough guy to push around. And when he's in front of you, good luck. Oh, boy, Fleming, he's met in the backfield, and he turns nothing into something. One guy hitting him isn't going to matter,
no.
Joe. It doesn't matter at all.
That's why I like that swing out to him earlier.
That swing pass when he had room in front of him, because we know he's got moves, right?
Yeah.
Now, you know, he can make you miss, never mind run you over. Take your choice. He'll do either one.
I think,
right?
I might run off the field.
Oh, my gosh. There were a couple of guys. We could see it from here. There were two guys on Woburn with Fleming bearing down with 10 yards between them going, please, no.
There goes Grady and Needham out right.
Grady and Stevie Needham swung right, and there's Tyson motion. Handoff up the middle to Fleming, and he gets pulled down here. You know what? You're looking at run the clock down football classic right now.
And fourth down.
It's fourth and two. I tell you, a first down here is a real stinger. But fourth and two, and they get a first down here, and they're going to take another 3 minutes off the clock. But smart playing right here. Just keep the ball on the ground. This, of course, is when they throw it fourth and two, right, Joe? Because that's when we say keep the ball on the ground. But they're going to call timeout right here, and Woburn is back on their heels. But the Rockets commanding 19-0 lead with 6 minutes to go here. And this one's, you know, it's a little bit closer than maybe the score would be, I would think. They're a pretty tough team, Joe, but they are really, really dominating on the interior.
Yeah, the second half has been already. Let's hope it stays that way. Still 7 minutes, 6:47 left.
6:47 to go, and we'll come back in a bit. All right, big, huge play right here. Why not go back to Fleming? Damari behind him, or he's next to him. Oh, there's movement there. That's going to move the Rockets back, and that one hurts because now it's fourth and seven. That may change up the play here. We're going to say keep it on the ground. Maybe they'll try to throw it here. You might see Paula come back in. I think there was movement, but he's trying to say if it was, movement on the Rockets. They jumped, and it's going to be now fourth and seven. You might see them change up the entire play here. It could be a pass play coming. So Troy is on the sideline with his helmet off right now. They may have said, that's enough of a game for you. Let's get you rested.
Yeah, he was out last week, so.
He got dinged up a little bit over on that play on the kickoff. And at this point, listen, you just put it, it's who's up next, right? The Rockets are so deep with skill position players that Damari goes in there, and he's going to be our quarterback here. I'd love to see him throw the ball. Damari was slinging the ball in practice. How about that seam pass to DeRoss? See him do the same exact thing.
No
get
receivers.
The I formation. Oh, he is going to throw it. He looks, he throws it. Oh, no. Almost picked off right there. He tried to swing it out to Needham, and he gets dropped. That guy would have had nothing but daylight there, and all of a sudden there's a game. But the Rockets fortunate on that drop right there. But Woburn's going to take over first and 10 from their own 25. All right, first and 10 here for Woburn with 6 minutes to go. They're going to ask a lot of this Rocket line again. Watch from the start throwing the ball. Got Conroy, Dwyer, Tice. Whole new defense back there. Oh, boy.
Big rush.
Throws it there. He jumps it down. He pulls it down. Good coverage by Kenyon. And an excellent, excellent catch by that player out there on the other side. I think he made one earlier. And it was a one-on-one with Kenyon. He had good coverage. And credit the Woburn receiver right there. But it's going to be first and 10 from the 42. All right, here we go. It's first and 10 here. Nice pass and catch right there. They can do it and look for them to do a lot more of it now with 6:14 and running right now. Oh, the ball's on the ground. Wow, very fortunate to hold on to it. Lynchy all over him. It's going to make him pay for that one. So they miss it right there. They're going to call timeout and regroup. And we'll come back in a sec. All right, here we go. We just wanted to get, there's Adam Pollock's new dog right there. I think it's Sadie. Let's ask Olivia what the dog's name is to confirm it. But there's Adam Pollock's new dog bringing them good luck here, hanging out. A couple of fans there, too. Look at the little girl here playing with them. Good stuff here as we have a break in the action. All right, here we go. It's going to be second and call it 15 after the fumble. It's back to pass right across the middle. Oh, boy, he comes down again. This guy has tremendous hands. Number 85 here, Jonathan Grady all over him. He spins backwards, and they're going to keep this thing going. They're going no huddle here. Grady's all over him. That kid has made some big, big catches. Great hands over there. Looks like Gronk. Back to pass again. Oh, boy, he is hammered.
Oh, my goodness.
He runs right into the truck that is Lynchy. And Foxy on one side and Beckenhuis on the other. There were three guys coming in there. He steps up to avoid Foxy and Beckenhuis, and guess who he met? Lynchy head on. Oh, that's like running into a girder at you know, it's unbelievable. What a great play by Lynchy. Man, he felt that one, didn't he? See what happens? We bring up these guys' names, and then they just make us look good, Joe.
They do.
Right? Beckenhuis and Foxy came in on the side. He steps up like he's going in the pocket. Guess what? There's no pocket. There's only Lynchy. Rude greeting by Lynchy on that quarterback. Now they're rethinking the pass. They get an I formation here. He's going to pass. Yeah, he just needs someone to block for him. Oh, boy, right there. Oh, Deemer was in there. He gets around him, and he's got a big seam there. He tries spinning. I think that's – is that Lynchy come all the way across the field to make a tackle? But Deemer was in there. He got around him. And look at Lynchy. He makes a tackle on the other side of the field.
All over.
Puts a hit on him. He does. He gets a lot of yardage there, but not enough for the first. It's third and short here. Clear four-down territory. 4 minutes to go in the game and counting. They change that formation. The quarterback's like, I need some help here, guys. You're killing us on the line here. He's going to swing out there. This time, Deemer keeps him inside. Look at this guy. His second one-handed catch of the day. He is pulling down everything, this kid. Everything. First down. It's sort of fun to watch. Of course, it's fun to watch when you're up 19-0, yeah. Joe, right? But that thing's over his head. One-handed grab. He pulls it down. Zach Kennedy can't believe it. He's all over him. Kennedy's got great coverage. And this guy's going skying and pulling him down with one hand.
Short of tackling him before the ball gets there. Well,
here comes 33. Joey Gilligan in there. Spell Foxy. I don't know what we have. We have another timeout here. It looks like
referee's time.
Referee timeout here. They're going to switch up a couple of players. We'll be back in a minute. Right now.
There they are, Tim.
Guys, let me tell you something. The reason why we have a timeout here is we were just praising DeCrescenzo and DeRoss over there. They get the chains tangled up with each other.
They started trick-or-treating early.
They have one job to do. Did DeCrescenzo put his mask back on? He couldn't see down below his feet? Sometimes those masks are dangerous. You can't see low. He might have had his mask on, and now there is an absolute.
DeRoss is up.
DeRoss is up. He's moving. Oh, my gosh.
Everybody's okay.
You know what? Golf clap right there for Paul DeRoss and Steve DeCrescenzo. They're still one of the guys, they had wrapped it up with a yard marker.
Oh, it's the yard marker guy.
You know what? Let's see. If that's another Reading guy, we got to find out who it is. But we have a break in the action here. By the way, I was hoping to watch the end of the Patriots game, and now DeCrescenzo and DeRoss have made that impossible. Oh, it's a high snap right there. Sean Beckenhuis in there early. Right in there. Joey Gilligan rips
awesome
him down.
Joe Gilligan.
Wow. I tell you, that one looked just like the last play with Lynchy. Beckenhuis is in on the outside. He steps up. Gilligan grabs him and throws him down. He threw that thing down like his father throws down meatballs.
Or anybody who tells him the Patriots score.
Oh, yeah. Do not say anything. But things are going very well for the Pats right now. About as well. Oh, low snap there. He throws it across the middle. Oh, this kid. Oh, my gosh. Pat Dwyer had great coverage there and makes a great tackle. And that kid, listen, the quarterback's just throwing it in his general direction.
The kid is having a game.
He is making this quarterback look like he's something because
he's just dumping that ball.
He is throwing it just near him, and he's pulling the ball down. So, wow, what a great player there. And I think his number is 85. Great player for Wu, but Redding takes the timeout now to take a breather with about 3 minutes to go. I think they did stop the clock anyway. And love to keep him off the scoreboard here, but I think what you're probably going to see here is they're going to try to get a quick strike and then onside's kick, Joe. We'll come back in a sec. 2:44. 2:44.
2:44 left in the fourth.
Okay. All right, hey, the clock gets reset to the correct time of 2:44 left in the game here. Oh, low snap, handoff up the middle. And he cuts back. He got some room. He gets stacked up immediately. Who's in there on the tackle? Let's see if I can pick him out of there.
I'm going to say Lynchy again.
It could have been Needham in there right there.
Deemer
was in there. It might have been. I'm trying to see who was in that tackle. But nice job right there. Beckenhuis is in on every single play. It's going to be a pass across the middle, and he catches it here. Hey, nice coverage by Kenyon. A little bit of justice for that kid. That kid has pulled down more great passes. He looks like just a big dude, doesn't he? But he has got great hands. You know, Wubern's Gronk over there gets on the board here, and that kid deserves it. He's been pulling down bad passes, good passes, any passes, and he's pulling them in. And let's see what they do here. 19-6, Joe. You know, I don't know what, you know, 19-7, 19-6, I don't think it makes a difference. So I think you might see him go for one here. We got Deemer, Masucci, Lynchy on that line. Joey Gilligan. Oh, boy. Look. Oh, he gets around. He was just got around, and he gets in there. Just got around Beckenhuis. He came in on a little bit inside track, and he goes in for the extra point. So with just about 2 minutes left, maybe just before the two-minute warning, it's the Rockets 19, Woburn 7. You got to look for something on sides here for sure, Joe.
I would think so.
The onsides kick right here, Joe. You get some of the hands team up front. DeRoss and Grady. It's a low kick there. It's picked up by Lucas. Lucas Fleming picks it up, and he throws himself harder into the ground than anyone has all season.
The ground is sorry now.
Oh, my God. Yeah. I tell you, right now the turf is saying, mercy, have mercy on us, Lucas.
It's a dent.
That's a smart play, though, right? Yep. Grab the ball, fall on it. It's going to be 2:04 right here. We don't know if it's right there. It's close to two-minute warning. Look for the Rockets to keep it on the ground, which these guys have not been able to stop. We get Kajander and Beckenhuis. You know Kajander. He's going to be thrilled to hit somebody. Pumping up the you can see Kajander with the headphones on earlier, listening to a little bit of the death metal, getting them fired up. This one goes to Beckenhuis. He follows Kajander. Big hole, and he runs over number 45 and drags him for another 2 yards. So big run by Beckenhuis, and that is the two-minute warning. So Rockets, man, they have looked great, haven't they, Joe?
They really have. This might be their best game of the year.
This one's going to be interesting to see where they finish first or second, Joe, because they are undefeated. Acton-Boxborough, assuming they win today, and Acton-Boxborough might have had a cupcake on the schedule. I think they said strength of schedule, which may give it to the Rockets.
We have had a tough schedule.
There's a keeper for Jay. He switches hands and gets outside for almost maybe a yard or two. But we played a very tough schedule. And if it is strength of schedule first and head-to-head matchup, you may see the Rockets get the first place. If not, at the very least, they had second. And looking at the standings, it looks like either a team that they've handled before or someone with a lesser record. So that first or second slot is huge here. And the Rockets have there's going to be two losses in a row for Woburn. You know what? That's no good going in the playoffs because they're going to have to face some brass.
Yes.
That Woburn team's going to be running into Everett, running into Drakett. You know, they probably won't see AB in the first round. That one, look at Fleming. Oh, gosh. He has been an absolute horse. He looks like Earl Campbell out there, doesn't he?
He does.
We're dating ourselves with Earl Campbell, but you know what? He was my favorite runner of all time, Joe.
I'll go Barry Sanders.
Yeah, well, listen, Sanders was awesome.
Yeah.
But
sweetness, too.
Well, you know what? You could also say Kajander is like Campbell, too, because Campbell would just as soon run over you than go around you, too. He could do both. But what a great play right there. Look at Jay. He's like, get out of here, Jay. Go rest yourself. You've done enough. And then he's shaking his head. You know what? That's what you want to see. Somebody shake their head getting pulled out of a game that they have in hand with less than a minute to go.
Having fun.
They're clapping on the sidelines right now, the Rockets. And they're kneeling on the ball for the victory, Joe. They're going to let this one run out.
I think that's it, Tim.
And you know what? What an absolutely awesome game right here for the Rockets. And listen, we're going to come back in a bit and see the playoffs.
There they go.
Let's walk right down on camera. Oh, there we go. Hey, the Rockets line up right now, and what a game today. They showed Woburn that the undefeated Rockets were clearly the toughest team that Woburn Trojans have seen this year. But what a great job by the Rockets here. You know what? There's going to be a little presentation down on the field, Joe. Let's do some online stuff and see if we can get it on here, okay?
Sounds good.
Do it.
Make it early.
Yeah. Yeah.
right? Beautiful. Make it early, but it might be like 5 to 7. But if we call practice, I expect everybody there. Okay?
And please tell your parents to check their emails because Coach will be sending out information about a lot of things.
Yeah, and it could be. But it could also be Tuesday night, so we'll see, okay? The other thing is, two more things. We're going to shake hands because we always do. Second, you guys are going to get flowers. Now, we don't need a flower for everybody, but we have, I think, 10 or 12 cheerleaders and coaches there. So I want everybody to go over there. I want you to make a line on the white line, all right? And then the guys who get flowers are going to hand flowers to the girls and the coaches. And everybody's going to clap and thank them because it's been a great season with these girls, okay?
Yeah.
All right, boys. Hey, see you. Hey, it might be two, three.
Grab those showings.
Hey, wait a second. Hey, boys, listen up. First, we're going to shake hands. So line up.
Hey Joe, I just turned on the ambient mics. Let me.
I'm going to switch these things back to us here. We're right down on the field. Hey, couple of stars of the game right here Sean Beckenhuis. There you go, Shawnee. Nice job. Patrick DeRoss, super game today.
DeRoss.
Here's Danny O'Connor right here. Dom DiCrescenzo, Lucas, we're in here. Great job. There's Lynch,
and
we brought
up
with him.
Tim.
Yeah, let's get it down here. I like it too, huh? End of the regular season, and guess what? Rockets are going on undefeated here.
8-0.
Hey, traditional handshake with the coaches. They started this year. Our team goes through the line after every practice, every game, shakes hands with all our coaches, and now they're going to line themselves up on the white line here and give a little tribute to our cheerleaders right here. Boys line up right here. Joe, let's move down, see if we can get it going here.
Here's Lynchy.
There's Lynchy here.
It's good to see these guys the hats.
Let's get all the guys here. Yeah, you know what? This is.
Masucci.
Get all the boys here. Coach Richie Marshall, see up close. Hi, Coach. You just made it. Great job, buddy. Give me that. Nice.
This is our last regular season game here. Probably our last game on this field as Pop Warner players, except for some of them. Okay? We want to say thank you. You guys have done a great job, and we heard you did a super job yesterday.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Dan, I'll take your flowers.
Hey, great job here, Joe. Joe, we were talking about this is the last game, regular season Papuana game for a lot of guys. So the only two guys coming back are going to be Damari. Damari's right in front of us. There he is. Oh, look at this. Look at these guys. This is like the champagne game afterwards. We get Damari giving flowers to the coaches. Coach Pollock and his sons right here. Right here is Troy. We got Coach Adam Pollock. We got Ryan Pollock. I heard Ryan talk upstairs. Sounded like his dad. I thought he was in trouble. Sounds just like him. So we're down here afterwards, regular season 8-0, Joe. How awesome is that?
8-0. It's a tough game against good teams every week.
Good team, very, very good teams this week. And you know what? There's a couple of things that I think these guys are going to want to present the coaches. We put some stuff together. So we will we'll come back in a sec.
I don't see a drop of water on it.
All right, here. Hey, the Rockets are getting together for a team picture here. Joe, get you take a picture here. You send it off to us. We'll get them all going here.
Hang on.
What are we looking at?
1, 2, 3.
There's our Rocket team and coaching staff right now, undefeated.
Wow, guys. Stay stuck. A lot of people taking pictures.
Woohoo!
I think
I did video.
Oh, it is. It's the coach.
Go Hawks.
Here we are. We get the coach and staff lining up right here. Oh, my gosh.
I'll tell you, Joe Dwyer, unbelievable job this year. Played by Mike. Who's your sidekick?
I don't know. He's got a lot of talent. He's got a lot of promise.
Hey, Coach Mike Masucci, I tell you, I'm not even going to bring up on camera here that he owes me $50 from going out the other night, but that's okay. Oh! Oh, look at that. You owe me nothing, brother. You owe me nothing. Deputy Chief of Chelsea Fire right there. Here we go. The boys right here are going to present something to the coaches. They got some gifts for these guys. We'll get a little bit of that. This is, hey, cool to have a little extra time right down here in the field here, Joe.
Like I said, it's good to see them without that hat.
Jay Kajander right here. He was a beast all year long. He was outstanding.
No one around that end.
No one wanted to see Jay coming down on him. He just assumed run you over.
Hey, no, looks pretty good, baby.
Coach DeMar thinks the bubble wrap is his present. Absolutely thrilled over there.
He's
going to work it out for the next 4 hours right now.
Coach Gilligan, thanks boys, from the start of the season, everything I said, right? I was hot, but was I right?
Great season for the Rockets. Here come the playoffs. We'll get back to you later. Take care, guys.
Let's go.